Hey guys, Sino, I'm here with another StarCraft 2 commentary. This time it's going to be Maka as the Yellow Terran at the, what is this, 3 o'clock? Up against Zhang Minchul, who is Iron, I believe, as the Red Protoss at the 12. So Maka is ranked number 4 on the Korean servers, and I believe his opponent Iron is ranked 79th. So still, both players pretty highly ranked. And let's see, this is going to be on Metalopolis, close air spawn. So this is, I'm not too sure on these, on this matchup, on this map, with these spawn points. I'd assume that this would benefit Protoss a little bit more because they generally have better mobility. But if Maka decides to go for that M&M&M build, then he could certainly just play around with these ledges with drops. Normal gateway time actually a little bit early, coming down at 11. In general, it's better to, well, more usual to see it around 12, 13, but whatever. This barracks going down at a normal time. Sure. Both players sitting at scouts, and it looks like Maka will be scouting the correct direction. So, let's see. Maka did do fairly well in his GSL games. I don't really want to spoil that. I'm just going to say that he did well. And he played very solidly against his opponent, Focus. Grabbing that gas, sure. Still no scout out. Our, Iron still doesn't know what's going on in Maka's base. He will send... He's finally going to get that scout on the way now, but Maka's going to see everything that's going down in Iron's base, and it's nothing too interesting, really. This all looks pretty standard. That core going up, still no Zealot on the way, because a lot of players just skip that first Zealot. Orbital Command going up, yeah, very, very normal right here. Actually going to get a reactor, that's kind of strange, so... He doesn't have a factory in the way, and he's getting a reactor, which means early pressure from Marines is really the only option he has. Yeah, that's okay. So, Iron is going to scout this and know that it's coming. He's going to Chrono Boost that first Stalker out. Also get that Warp Gate tech on the way. But he's probably going to need a little bit more than that. It's going to be difficult to hold off a massive Marines with just one gate's worth of units, even if it is Chrono Boosted. Second barracks now on the way. Maka taking this tower. So... Okay, now the factor's on the way, but... Yeah, he's just masking up Marines now. He might be going for an early push using that first tank, which I kind of mentioned in the game between July and August. July, Zerg, and August. But he might just do a Marine Hellion push, which is also, it's kind of uncommon. You don't really see it too much. The tank Marine push is generally a lot more popular. Actually getting a tech lab on the second barrack. This wall is kind of strange. So yeah, getting that tech lab, getting stim, alright. Yeah, and he's got a lot of Marines out now. This is going to be 7 Marines. And a Marauder on the way. Looks like he's going to be switching it off with the, oh no, he's sending it to scout, okay. Sure, okay. He will be going for that M&M&M build then. I thought he was just going to do a timing push with a tank, but instead he's just going to go for this M&M&M. And he's going to be fine, he should be okay. His opponent still doesn't have too much out. He's getting that rogue facility, pretty normal. This factory in a little bit of danger. But he will be able to retreat in time. This is a little strange getting this bunker here. Yeah, I'm not sure why he thinks that he needs a bunker. It just seems like it's not really a waste of money because he can just salvage it, no problem. But still, it's kind of getting that starport up. I'm a little surprised he didn't go earlier ghosts because ghosts are just so incredible against Protoss. But maybe he wants that mobility of those medevacs, and he's looking to expand as well. second gate, we're finally going to go down here from Iron. He's got this Robo Bay up, getting that First Observer out, pretty normal from him. Also getting a Twilight Council up, so he might be doing some blank play, which is very fun on Metalopolis, because you have these really, really long ridges. I think it's a little more fun on Lost Temple, but still. Very, very useful on maps like Metalopolis, where you can just play around with these ledges very nicely. Looks like this Marine might get that probe. Yep, just barely. Stalker and Zealot gonna come out and kill it off, so we'll be able to take control of that tower once again. Just get that scouting information. This guy should probably turn into a warp gate. There we go. Next mission just about done. And we'll be able to take it pretty easily. He's got a nice defense position. It looks like we'll be seeing Blink. A Raven actually on the way. Well, from Maka, so he's going to be able to snipe this Observer for one. But, yeah, there we go. So, Raven play. You actually don't see Raven as much as I really expect. They are decently powerful spellcasters, although they do need that upgrade for the Hunter Seeker Missile. The auto turret is decent. Point defense drone, very, very powerful. It looks like he will be looking to move out here. He has a decent force over here, but I would be waiting for that. Well, he should have the energy for that point defense drone pretty soon. He's got a decent force over here. Now, yeah, he shouldn't be engaging until he has that point defense drone, until he's ready to... Ooh, looks like he's going to snipe the Raven. Almost gets it. Not quite. So it looks like this Raven will stay another day. This medevac out now. Might be doing some drops later on. Probably just going to use it for healing right now. And Maka now taking that expansion. And Iron actually taking his expansion as well. So we've seen this heavy stalker build from Iron so far. Very understandable considering he's gone Blink. And Blink is just very, very handy to have. Especially when you already got these observers out. That Raven now has the energy for a point defense drone, so he's going to be able to defend this very nicely if he can get into position. Come on. Okay, and he's going to force Iron to retreat here. We'll go engaging, and looks like he has enough to take down these stalkers, but yeah, Iron going to do the smart thing, just going to run away. Ravens are annoyingly slow. 2.25. I think they move the same speed as the Marines. Yeah. Marking a few more kills over here, but nothing too major. Another gateway going down, so what, 4 gates and a row facility off of 2 bases. You're going to have more than enough money. You should probably be teching as well here. Maybe getting Storm. Storm would be nice. Let's see, eBay going down, second factory going down. Oh, did he lose his first one? He probably lost his first one. Yeah, it looks like he lost his first one, so... Getting a replacement factory, and it's on a tech lab as well. Engagement over here? No, not quite yet. Scanning ahead to see his opponent's army. Is he going to elevator some troops? No, he's just going to snipe off this pylon, it looks like. Nice job there. Might be able to get this road facility as well. Wow. There we go. Iron going to move into position, take out those marauders. But Maka doing a good job actually just microing around those units, making sure that he can get in range of that road facility. And Iron going to come in here again. Where's the point defense drone? No, looks like he doesn't really want to commit to this. He's lost a lot of units over here. He doesn't really have a comparable army. Oh, this robo facility at 8 HP. Come on, take it down. This Raven not long for life either. Come on, just one shot. Even an auto turret. I'm going to move in here. Point defense drone, very well in range. Doing a nice job of stopping those stalkers, but it's out of energy already. They can only do, I think it's like 10 shots worth of defense. The rest of his army, pretty skimpy. But it looks like he does have enough marauders to take down these stalkers, and he's going to force them to run. They should be able to blink. Yep, there we go. So now it looks like Maka is going to be able to push to this natural pretty much uncontested. Is there a drop by here? Yep. Actually, even using feedback over here, he was attacking to these Templar. But looks like Maka's in a very nice position over here. Wow, this drop was really effective. Took out tons and tons of guys. I'm going to have to spoil this a little bit and go back and look at that. Speed this up a bit. There we go. Wow, just two Marauders did tons and tons of damage. So while this is going on, he's still microing these guys. He still hasn't taken down this robe facility. There we go, dropping down those Marauders, able to take down, let's see, one probe, two probes, three probes, four probes, five probes, six probes, seven probes, eight probes, nine probes, 10 probes, 11 probes, 12 probes. Wow. These Marauders being absolutely heroes. 13 probes, 14 probes, 15 probes, 16 probes, 17 probes, 18 probes, 19 probes, and now gonna retreat. Wow, 19 probes of two Marauders and a medevac. Absolutely incredible job here from Maka. And in addition to this, he's kept his opponent's army on the run. His opponent is barely mining. Let's look at that income. Yeah, quadrupled the income in minerals. This gas only 1.5 times, but still, absolutely enormous differences in terms of income. Maka going to be able to just run away from the game with this macro army. His opponent just doesn't have anything left. Iron, just devoid of any real units. His point defense drone still alive. And these Templar would need to have just incredible storms for Iron to hold this off, but that's not going to be the case. There we go, Iron going to GG, and Maka going to take this game extremely solidly from that drop, from his army control. So very nice job there from Maka, and hope you enjoyed it, and GG.